care about yourself.
Hallelujah.
This is not the way.
Hallelujah.
This is not the way. This is murder. This is murder.
Murder. The name
How many
of Jesus
babies
Christ.
Have begun for you to wake up?
Yes.
Jesus.
How many babies have to be killed for you to wake up?
Come on.
Does everybody know
what
Jesus
wants?
Quiet!
Jesus is speaking!
In the name of Jesus.
I said, y'all are accountable! Clap your heart out, you have to give it a chance. You will 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 have to give it a
chance. In the name of Jesus.
You don't. I don't think you have an idea of what you're really doing. I don't think you really do. If you did, you would not be standing here. I'm trying to warn you.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
I'm trying to tell you. All this noise and all these distractions will not give you a way out. You're going to have to face the truth. You're going to have to face the truth. Every single day that you're standing here, you are helping a woman, a man, to lose their soul.
Yes.
And you're losing yours along with it. I'm trying to warn you.
All
that fake parting, you're not for women. You hate women because you hate yourself.
Yes.
You hate yourself. You hate yourself. You hate yourself. You don't know yourself. You didn't make you. God made you. He didn't come up with you. God made you. You hate yourself. Baby girl. That's why I cut it. You hate yourself. You will never be sent here. Y'all hate yourself. All that fun is gonna cut it. Y'all gonna have to answer. Y'all hate yourself. I don't know who hurt you, but I'm telling you. I don't know who broke your heart. I don't know who molested you. I don't know who abused you. I don't know who raped you. I don't know who abused you. I don't know who offended you. But I'm telling you right now. I'm telling you right now. This right here is not gonna save you. This right here is not healing you. It is killing you. It is sending you faster to your demise. I'm trying to tell you. I'm trying to tell you. And all that loud music, and all that fake dance, fake friends, fake tournaments, y'all don't even love. You don't know what love is. You don't know what it's all fake.
It's all fake.
Fake everything. Fake colors. Nothing is true about you. But one thing is yours. The more you do it, and you pay attention, I'm pleading with you. I am pleading with you. Quit this.
Place.
Where's this place? At the end of the day, you're
going
to have to answer.
Let yourself free.
All that's wrong. It's okay. You're not talking about me. You're talking about Jesus. You don't know who you're mocking. You're not mocking me. You're mocking Jesus. You're not mocking me. You're mocking the true enemy God. That's who you're mocking. Y'all not mocking me. Y'all can spit on me. Y'all can beat me. Y'all touching Jesus. Y'all can ridicule me. Y'all not ridiculing me. Facing me. But you're going to have to give an account. You're going to have to give an account. I'm trying to tell you. This is not going to save you, folks. It's not going to make you feel better. It can look fun for a moment. But then when you're in silence, when you don't have noise to distract you, you have to wrestle with yourself. And I'm telling you, folks, In Jesus' name. Who lied to you? You've been lied to. You've been bamboozled. You are deceived. You are deceived. You know, I would pray, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing. But I believe you know what you're doing.
They know better.
See, I can't even pray, Father, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing.
You know what
because you know what you're doing.
You know what you're
doing. I'm telling you, this is not.
You hear the truth, you rebel
against it. This is not vindicating you. This is not vindicating you. I'm telling you.
In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. In the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah.
You know that you're ashamed of what you do. Because you don't wear that glove. temporary tattoos because you're ashamed to get religious ones. You know you're guilty. Murder. Set yourself free. Pick up your bed.
Affiliated medical services, abortion now in Milwaukee.
Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Let the truth be told! This place is evil!
We've got some men and women of God preaching truth. It is time to turn away from this place of death. You cannot say you don't have people out here to help you. There are Christians out here to help you. They're here out of love. Please come out, no matter how long you've been in here. Come out and let us help you. To help you and your child. Do not murder your child. These people are here to make sure that you become a murderer of your child. Don't do that. Turn away from this evil. Turn away from this place of death. Turn away from the cold-blooded murder of your child. We have here is a line of death squads. The death squads will take the murder child.
In the name of Jesus.
They're,
do you know they designed this place to kill
the babies?
They want to protect you because they want you to kill the babies. That's what they're doing. They're protecting you from that.
Please come out and let us help you. Do not choose murder this day. Choose to love your child, mother and father. Come look at the signs out here. Come look at what they're doing to children. This is great evil in the eyes of God. God's word says that he hates the hands that shed innocent blood. You will be held accountable for what you have done here today, for what you're doing. You'll be held accountable for the people here who have warned you. You cannot say that you have not been warned about the murder of your child, about eternal hell. You cannot say you have not been warned. You can't say there's nobody here to help you. But you can say that you refused, you rejected all the offers of help. That's what you can say. Will you love your child enough to not murder them? But love your child enough to let someone else adopt them? I can give you the contact information right now for a local couple that wants to adopt your baby, that wants to adopt your child. Will you let them do that? So many parents in this culture that hate children unto death. Our nation is filled with people who are thirsty for more blood. Whether they escort children in to be murdered, or they come to a place like this to pay an assassin to murder their children, it is cold-blooded murder, it is sin in the eyes of God. And you will help be held accountable to this evil that you're involved in. Please turn away now, before it's too late. Once your child is dead, that's it. Your child will not come back from the grave. And you'll live your life as a murderer of your child. Possibly never to give birth to a child.
What's going on?
Why would you choose to reject the blessings from the hand of the Lord?
Public sidewalk. I can stand here just like you. Do not push me, please, and do not get over me, please.
Why would you choose the murder of children this day?
What is going on?
Great, they want to be preached to, Edmund.
You know what? I'm a loaded.
Give them the gospel. That's what they want to hear about Jesus. You want to know about a man who died for you, who died for your sins, that you can be cleansed and you can be rejoined with the true and living God? Do you want to know? Do you want to know about the Lord and that he says he known you from your womb? He has a destiny for you. Do you know that? And that he designed you to be kings and queens under his authority? But you cannot be that without accepting the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So let me tell you something right now. Jesus loves you. It's available. You can repent right now. You can repent right now and walk away from this thing. You can be cleansed of this thing. The Lord can make you brand new. Don't you know? It's available. As long as you got breath in your belly, you can repent right now. Jesus is available to you. He's not just for us. He's for everybody. He's for Gentiles and Jews alike in the name of Jesus. You can repent. You can be free from your anguish because you women are full of anguish. In the spirit of feminism, you women are rebellious women who hate women and hate men. And I see the spirit of Jezebel upon these women. But don't you know the Lord can free you? The Lord can free you, sweetie. He can free all of you. You can be born again. You can be brand new. You don't have to continue to act like a Jezebel. Do you know what happened to Jezebel? Jezebel's body fell and she shattered like jello on the ground and it's burning in hell right now. You don't want to be a Jezebel. You don't want that for yourself. The Lord says it's better to chop off your hand and then to have your whole body go into damnation. It's better to pop out your eye. It's better to get your phone out your hand rather than burn in hell because you refuse good counsel and the truth that Jesus is alive, that he's risen from the grave, and his blood is available to you right now. In the name of Jesus, you can be cleansed. You can be born again. You can be born again and brand new in the name of Jesus. I know you want to know how much Jesus loves you. He loves you so much. It's available to you, baby. It's available to all of you. Jesus loves you. He 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 loves all of you. In the name of Jesus, it's available right now.
Excuse me.
The Lord's blood is available for all who will just accept the truth.
Thank you. Excuse me.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For all who will accept it, Jesus is available to you. We're just here to give you Jesus. Because that's what y'all want. Y'all want Jesus, so we're going to give him to you in the name of Jesus. And maybe you'll feel some conviction in your heart and choose to not escort a woman to slaughter. Choose not to lead another woman to baby to death in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, stop adding this sin upon your hands. Stop adding this innocent blood upon your hands. It's not worth it, sister. It's not worth it. You look so unhappy. I see the unhappiness in you. It oozes out of you. It's literally manifesting, baby. Are you not ready to be set free so that Christ can cleanse you? I mean, come on, girl. Everybody can see it. Everybody can see it. I'm telling you, it's obvious you're unhappy. But Jesus can fill you. He can make you happy. You don't have to go home to eat and gluttony and all of these things like that. Because that's a spirit. That's a spirit against you, sweetie. It's making you miserable. You can repent. You can repent, sister. You can repent right now. It's available. And especially for you. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. But he wants to do so much for his daughters. He wants to help his daughters. He wants to help them. Especially the older women. Come on, old ladies. Grown women, y'all supposed to be guiding the children and teaching them. You're leading our young women to do foolish things like this. You're old enough to be somebody's grandma. And you out here leading somebody to the slaughter? You too old for that. You too old to be out here. That's crazy. Older women are supposed to grow. They're supposed to mature and teach the younger women. You're with them, hanging with them, trying to be like them, and you're leading them to the slaughter.